I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Multiple sclerosis, or MS as it's called, is an immune-mediated disease that attacks the body's central nervous system. More than 400,000 Americans are diagnosed with MS every year. What causes MS? How do you treat it? Joining us is Dr. Charles Smith. He is a neurologist with Scripps Clinic in La Jolla, California. Dr. Smith, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
What causes multiple sclerosis?
Well, that's the $64,000 question. We don't know what causes multiple sclerosis. We believe it's caused by a viral infection, possibly Epstein-Barr virus, the virus that causes infectious mono, probably acquired when you're very young, in your adolescence, and then it remains dormant for all those years until it comes out when you're 30, 35 years of age.
So what are the symptoms of MS?
Well, there are many symptoms of MS, and that's part of the reason why it's sometimes difficult to diagnose, because they can be so different from person to person. But the common ones are fatigue, urinary symptoms, bowel symptoms, erectile dysfunction in men, and failure to climax in women. Sometimes pain is a big issue for some patients, problems walking, balance, for example, slurred speech, swallowing issues. The list goes on. It's quite a long list.
And the symptoms are very different from person to person. Why is that?
Well, it's all location, location, location. So it depends where the spots occur. As I said, one person will present. First symptom is blurred vision with pain in the eye. Another one presents with numbness from the waist down, two totally different presentations. It really depends where the spots of MS are. So MS causes attacks that leads to damage, especially of the myelin sheath, the insulation of the nerve fibers. And those damaged areas produce the symptoms. And it depends where the damage is occurring. That's why location is so important.
And these symptoms come and go. Why is that?
Well, in MS, you have attacks where the immune system invades the central nervous system, the brain, the spinal cord, and the optic nerves, causes damage, which may or may not cause a symptom. And then somehow the attack turns off after a couple of weeks, typically. And then the area heals and becomes asymptomatic, no symptom anymore. And the reason for that asymptomatic is because perhaps the damage wasn't strong enough to produce a scar, just caused some inflammation that healed. Or perhaps the nervous system worked around the damaged area, because we know that the healthy parts of the brain and spinal cord and optic nerves can compensate for damage near the where the spot is, that can make the spot not any more symptomatic.
Who is most at risk for this?
Young women who are white. So most common person to get multiple sclerosis is a Caucasian woman. The ratio of female to male is currently about 3 to 1. When I was in training in the 1970s and early 80s, the ratio was 1.4 to 1. So what's happened over the years is that women have become more and more vulnerable to getting multiple sclerosis, possibly because of hormonal differences between men and women. We just don't know the answers.
A lot of other things can cause pain and numbness and weakness, muscle spasms. So how do you diagnose MS?
MRI is the most important diagnostic tool in multiple sclerosis. So we MRI the brain and the spinal cord. What we're looking for is spots with a characteristic shape, a characteristic appearance as far as where they are and how they're oriented. And if they seem to make sense for multiple sclerosis, then we've ruled out other mimics, then we can say multiple sclerosis is the diagnosis.
So how do you treat MS?
Well, there are two aspects to this question. Number one, you treat the disease process so it won't progress and cause disability down the road. And the second thing we do is we look at the symptoms a person has to try and help them with that to improve their quality of life. So with regards to the first treatment, that is disease modification, disease course modification, we select one of the many medications that we have that will address the immune attack that's leading to the disease progress. And once that's done and the person is stable and confirmed to be stable, then we start managing it, well, coincidentally as well, the symptoms that a person has. The symptom management is a difficult aspect because none of the therapies really work 100%, but we try to manage those symptoms that have a a solution, like spasticity, like problems with bladder control, like fatigue, and so on. And then we refer patients to physical therapy and occupational therapy and speech therapy as needed so that we get them to be functioning as best as they can be.
Can MS be cured?
Alas, no, but I must say that the more recent treatments are now producing responses that are about 95% effective. And we call this NEDA, no evidence for disease activity. If we have achieved NEDA and we can maintain it, then the patient is essentially cured. I mean, there's no more disease progression.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
I think it's important to realize that there are so many therapies out there that help MS, and surely there's one that's right for the vast majority of MS people. So unlike in the past, where I would tell a person when there was no therapy, you know, hope for the best, now I can say, we can beat this. We can be positive about this because we will try whatever treatment we need to do to get you having a normal, full life. And there's a life after a diagnosis of MS, unlike there was in the past.
Dr. Smith, thanks so much for taking the time to be with us. We certainly appreciate it.
It's my pleasure.
If you want more information on how to treat multiple sclerosis, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media @Scripps Health. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.